Today, we'll take a look at the top 5 ways to use the built-in object tracker in Final Cut Pro. Number 1 is using the object tracker to track a title to a moving subject, and this is very simple. Just select the title you want to use for this, and instead of dropping it onto your timeline, drag this title over the viewer window. When you hover over an object or a person in your clip, Final Cut Pro will recognize it and fit the tracker to your object. Click the Analyze button to track your clip. It doesn't matter where your playhead is, Final Cut Pro will track your entire clip. Open the tracker drop-down to select what tracker properties you want to apply to your title and click Done. Replace your text in your title and use the on-screen controls to position it. It's that simple. Number 2 is censoring a moving subject, and this is also super simple. Open your effects browser and select the effect you want to use to censor your clip. Don't use the censor effect because it doesn't work with a tracker, but you can use any of the blur effects, or what I like using is the pixelate effect. Grab this effect and drag it over the viewer window. For my example, I want to censor one of the faces in my clip, so I'll move my tracker over it until Final Cut Pro recognizes it as a face. Click Analyze to track your clip. Once your track is finished, select the Shape tab and adjust the size and feather of your mask. Go to the Inspector window and adjust the amount of pixelation. If we play back our clip, this effect moves perfectly with our subject. Number 3 is using the object tracker to highlight or point out a subject. I'll use it to add an arrow to point out this lady in the crowd. This time, instead of dragging the effect onto our viewer window, we'll track this clip manually. Select the clip in your timeline, and in the Inspector window, scroll all the way down to Trackers. Click the plus button, and adjust the tracking grid in your viewer. We'll make this nice and small, but at the same time, large enough to track her face. For common objects like a face to get the best track, we'll switch the tracking method to machine learning. This way, you let Final Cut Pro know you're tracking a face, so even if it gets obstructed for a few frames, we should still get a good track. Click the Analyze button to track your clip. Next, let's add an arrow and add the tracking data to it from our clip to follow our subject. The arrow I'm using for this example is from Motion VFX's M-Frame 3 plugin. I'll add this above my timeline, adjust the appearance, and point it towards my subject. To add the tracking data from our bottom clip, with the arrow clip selected, open the Transform tool, and select the object track from the clip below it. I don't want this arrow to rotate, so I'll deselect rotation. Click Done to apply the position parameters from our bottom clip to the arrow so it perfectly follows our subject. Before we move on to the last two uses for the object tracker in Final Cut Pro, I want to take a few seconds to tell you about today's sponsor, Motion VFX. When it comes to quality plugins for Final Cut Pro, no one even compares to Motion VFX. The professional looking plugins look amazing, are super simple to install, and deliver exactly what they promise. Let's take M-Frame 3 for example. This plugin includes 50 vintage split screen effects for Final Cut Pro. You just drop onto your timeline, fill the drop zones, and you have this awesome looking split screen effect. You can customize basically any parameter in this effect from colors all the way down to lens dirt. And as a nice little bonus, you'll also get a few scribble elements, like the arrow I used in my last example, and even a few typography presets. It's little things like this you'll find yourself using over and over. Motion VFX has plugins for titles, generators, effects, and even a 3D tracker that's quite a bit more capable than what you get with Final Cut Pro. Click the link in the video description and see how Motion VFX can help you make better videos. Now, back to Final Cut Pro. Use number 4 for the object tracker in Final Cut Pro is adding realistic camera shake to your tripod shots. I do know Final Cut Pro comes with a built-in handheld effect, but honestly, it just looks fake. Using the object tracker can make it look much more realistic. What you'll need to do is take your camera and film a handheld shot of a simple subject. For best results, make sure it's in focus and has good contrast. Import this clip into Final Cut Pro and add it above your clip. Add a tracker. Select an area you want to track, and this time, use the point cloud tracking method. This tracks individual pixels, and as long as there's nothing obstructing your tracking area, this will give you a much more accurate track. Analyze this clip, and in the inspector, rename the track. Move your clip under your timeline, select your top clip, and open up the Transform tool. From the Tracker drop-down menu, select your track, click Done, and scale up your original clip to fill a frame. And last, but definitely not least, is the locked-on stabilization effect. I've done a video on this before, but the object tracker has been updated, so I figure now is a good time for a refresher. Select your clip, add a tracker, and place a tracking square over the part you want to lock onto. Analyze your clip. Go to your inspector window and set the scale all amount to negative 100. Grab the same clip from your media browser and place it above your original clip. Select the Transform tool, and from the Tracker drop-down menu, select your object track from before. Open the Tracker drop-down again, and deselect Rotation. Click Done, and make sure the rotation value for this clip in the inspector is 0. To flip this clip the right side up, we need a negative scale value again, and since we're moving the frame around to keep our subject in the same spot, let's go a bit more, maybe negative 130. If needed, adjust your subject's position for this cool locked-on effect. Just one more thing before you go. If you're looking for some cool Final Cut Pro plugins and are considering purchasing from Motion VFX, I do get a small percentage from every sale. If you find these tutorials helpful, this is a great way to support my channel. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you back here next week.